Hey, good afternoon. Hey, Big Mike, thank you. Hey, welcome to the Leatherneck Comedy Tour. Enjoy yourself. Hey, move on up, because participation is key to this event. Make sure you have a good time. The bar is open. Big Mike's buying drinks back there. Go out there and enjoy yourself. Hey, if you laugh too hard and you shit your trousers, you got to go to the heads right over there. So make sure you run quickly so we don't have too much of a mess here, right? Now, with that context, hey, this is an R-rated show. Everybody's aware of this, right? So you may hear a few things that normally are not said in the work environment, right? That's right. You're supposed to say, yeah. No, you're supposed to say, hell yeah. So you may hear a few things that you may not agree with. If you do, you need to go back to work now, put your coveralls on, and get in that cold wind, okay? But if you don't mind, you're more than welcome to stay and enjoy yourself and participate in this awesome event, right? And again, go back and tell the word to all those sad faces that didn't come here today and let them know you had a good time, it was funny as hell, and you got to see Big Mike, right? All right. Hey, again, thanks, Big Mike.
Y'all give it up for Sergeant Major one time, man. I appreciate that. That's a cool Sergeant Major. Are y'all ready for this party to get started? Somebody say, hell yeah. Oh yeah. Say shit yeah. He said we can curse. I was waiting for the Sergeant Major to say we can curse. That's why I'm like, oh yeah, yeah, yeah. All right, y'all, I'm about to bring up our host for tonight. Fellas, how many fellas like some ladies that look good? I know my married couple, yeah, I know y'all do. I know, we got a special one for y'all, okay. Save me a seat, okay? All right. This lady I'm about to bring to the stage, she is funny as hell, okay? She's from San Diego, California. California in the building. You seen her on Chelsea's lately. You seen her on MTV's Punk. And she's also been on the Tonight Show. So I need y'all to make some noise. Start clapping right now. Give it up for your host right now, Miss Shayma Tesh.
What was that last song you were playing?
The Journey?
Yeah, that, no, not the, no, the one between that, the last one. I'm feeling it though.
Start it for the bottle.
What was that? Yeah.
Start it for the bottle, you want that?
Yeah, do it.
Okay, all right, you talk to her.
We're gonna do that, we're gonna do this again. I'm just feeling that music.
Oh, she was feeling
oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. All right, what was that? That made me wanna be a rap dancer.
All right, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, what? I'm not gonna twerk per se, all right? But I'm gonna do what my version, I guess, is what's gonna happen right now. Let's make this happen.
Are y'all ready?
Well, spontaneous, ladies and gentlemen. All right, this is a mic stand, not a pole, though. It's not gonna get that crazy. I'm just letting you know right now. It's not gonna, yeah.
Y'all
yeah.
Give it up one more time for the lovely Miss Shayma Tesh.
Started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team fucking here. Started from the bottom, now we here.
Make some noise, Yuma.
Started from the bottom, now the whole team here. Nigga, started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team here. Nigga, started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team fucking here. I done kept it real from the jump. Living at my mama's house, we'd argue every month, nigga. I was trying to get it on my own. Working all night, traffic on the way.
That's right. Okay, thank you. That's an introduction. Oh my God, I'm winded now. That's awesome. This is good fun. Nice having a DJ, huh? Isn't that awesome? I like it. Well, I did grow up in San Diego. That's true. And somebody booed San Diego. What the fuck? Thank you. No, my mom is a hippie, and everybody thought that was cool. Like, they were jealous of me growing up. And I'm like, my mom, she wasn't good at discipline. Although one time, she tried. She busted my brother for smoking hash because he was doing it wrong and wasting it. What the hell? Like, she tried to have that talk with me about drugs. Worst person in the world for that job. She's like, hey, man. Listen, I know you're going to experiment with pie because what are you, 9? I'm just worried if someone gives you weed, it could be laced and that's dangerous. Make sure you, hey, look at that. Make sure you bring it home and I'll test it for you.
What?
And I grew up with my stepdad because I grew up in California. You're not allowed to grow up with your real father in that state. I don't know if you guys have heard it. They passed a law now. It's illegal. But, I mean, hippie and a biker, you can't get more opposite than that, can you? You know, peace and love. Live to ride, ride to live, son of a bitch. Oh, really? You're a tough guy? Why do you have a wallet, you know, that with a chain that attaches it to your pants? What the hell kind of bullshit is that, you know? You don't look insecure. That is the most insecure fashion statement in the world, by the way. It's like, oh, I'll drop my wallet right away and never see it again. Oh, so you're out, what, $6? Maybe a Leonard Skinner ticket stub and a sketch your next shitty tattoo. Wow. So, and I grew up broke. I know you can't tell because I can afford to shop at nice stores like Ross. But government cheese. Anybody remember the government cheese? Yeah, and then they would give you a brick, and I never got that. But now when you think about it, there was a smart guy in that meeting. Like, what? Maybe they won't notice they're hungry if they're constipated. That's brilliant. Seriously, you're backed up. You're going to at least slow down at some point. I love this guy. And I think that's why I watch certain television shows. Like, I still watch The Springer Show every now and again because I miss my family. And if you're having a bad day, watch that show for 10 minutes. You feel better about your life. You ever see the people they're fighting over? Like, Jesus, he's got 6 teeth and 5 girlfriends. How does he pull that shit off? That's me. The person in the audience is great because they care about a stranger. Like, I wish I had friends that got my back like this. Like, oh, excuse me. Can I talk? Because that's right. I want to tell you something over there, girl. Mm-hmm. Oh, so you go, you done been with him for how long and he won't do that to you? Oh, hell no. Anybody got time for that? I need friends like that. Then the guy starts talking, right? Was I talking to you? I don't think so. I don't think so. You better talk to the fist because the hand is pissed, okay? I got 4 kids. I don't need no man telling me what I can and can't do, where I can and can't go, whenever I finna go, where I finna go, do what I finna do for myself. I'll take care of myself. You don't know me. You best get your skank ass out my face. Hells yeah. And those are the white girls half the time. You're like, what the hell? I lived in LA for a while. I had to move. Too fat for LA, man. That place is out of control. How many people agree with the plastic surgery? I'm not against it entirely, but I think it's gone too far. You know what, guys? You should know this, guys, because you know what women are doing now? They're doing vaginal rejuvenation. I know it's false advertising. It's like putting a fresh coat of paint on a really old house and then trying to pretend no one ever lived there before. You're not fooling anyone. They're gonna figure it out when they get inside, right? I see the wall's been marked and the carpet's been trampled. What the hell is going on? It's true. And there's just so much pressure. And that city, like of all the places I ever lived, I just feel like it's okay to be healthy. But like this woman, she had everything done. I'm walking behind her in the gym. I couldn't help but think, you're 80. Like, take a fucking nap. This is ridiculous. It's not like she was having fun in the gym. She was like, Jesus, I can't. Go around me, honey. Just go. Look, I'm playing hacky sack with my tits right now. So. Just go around me, honey. Finally, I had to say, excuse me, ma'am. We're on treadmills. Yeah. I can't go around you. But you know what? It's because of Hollywood. We try to live up to these unrealistic standards, right? Even guys have standards. It's not real. You can't live up to it. You know, like, you're not gonna look like you would in a magazine, right? You're not gonna be photoshopped in real life. You're not gonna have a skilled team of gay men chasing you around, spritzing your hair and adjusting lights. You can't. You ever go to the movies and see a love scene with something you can relate to? I don't. I think everything's too perfect. Just once I wanna hear a woman say something real, like, can I put my leg down for a second? It's cramping up. I just gotta try to work out that cramp. Wait, your elbow's on my hair now. Your elbow, I lift your, I'm pinned. Lift your elbow. I can't finish till you lift your elbow, actually. Just, yeah, no, you're close. Keep going. Oh, headboard, okay. That is a solid headboard, isn't it? Is that oak? That's, yes. No, I'm fine. I'm just bleeding a little. It's okay. not realistic for men either. You never see a passionate love scene in a movie where the guy stops to look at the lady in the middle of everything, like. I think it's rolling around. Not one time. You never see that, but I'm not bagging on you guys. You guys are pretty awesome about this. Men do the bulk of the work in bed. Guys, especially you young guys over here. Look at you young guys. I breastfeed you, for Christ's sake. Look at you. Later. Anyway. Kind of busy. But no, seriously, the guys do the bulk of the work, and we don't appreciate it as women until you guys ask us to get on top. And we're like, God damn it, ma! Like, inside, we don't tell you. Like, we try to accommodate you, but then you're up there, and it's, God, it's awkward, isn't it? Because you guys just, what is it with you guys that just stare? Why can't you, right? They stare at us. And then, I don't know, what, is this a show? Like, what am I supposed to do now? Like, it's, yes. Sometimes we get distracted because we don't know what you're staring at. Like, what the hell is this? Then we have a lot of pressure because you guys see everything, right? You know? And you don't make a facial expression or a noise to indicate that you like things like we do for you guys. No, you just look like you'd have rather have a fucking sandwich or something. I'm dying. Blank stare. But you do equal time tits to face. That's very nice. It's smart of you. You don't get yourself in trouble. But you're up there, and after a while, you know, it's just... We feel exposed, you see everything, right? We're like, oh, keep them up, keep them centered. You want a lazy eye nipple trailing off this way, this one's, it's a lot of pressure. You guys don't have that kind of pressure. You got it lucky, you're too busy suffocating us with your shoulder. You do that thing? That smash our face move, that's an awesome one. And then we make a noise sometimes and something hurts and you guys think we like it and then you do it more. I'm the man, oh, I'm dying. That's why we scratch your back sometimes. I'm trying to, I want to live. I can't breathe. Help. Up there, after a while though, what happened? Your thighs start to burn, right? Just know how much work that the women are doing. Because it's like after, I can't keep this going for 20 seconds. What are they doing? This is really, you ever switch to the one knee to try to save the other though? And it doesn't help? Now that's blowing out. You're just like, go around me, honey. I love it. The guys, there's something about the guys, though. You know, you guys could benefit from this knowledge because you guys are all clean cut. Look at you, right? I think you should make the carpet match the drapes. I think you should do something about that. Am I right? Because women, what do? You know that we do this crazy stuff to try. What'd you say? You have hair on your head, so I guess it doesn't. Is that what you're saying? Is you're... Bald eagle. All right, so, awesome, you got the Brazilian. That's nice. More guys should do that, is what I'm saying. Because women, we do this for you. This is how much you know that we love you guys, that we go through something that painful. It should be reserved for POWs, because that shit hurts. That is, like, the lady tries to warn you. You can't be warned about that kind of pain. You know, it's going to be a little sting. Oh, that's not so bad. Wow, I can't see. Is that normal? I can't see. Yeah, you could just leave the other side. Actually, I'll get myself. We do this to look nice for you. Meanwhile, other than Brazilian over here, meanwhile, pull down your pants, guys. Looks like a nest or something crazy happened there. Like a got a plucked chicken and some eggs milling around, like some kind of disappointing Easter basket. Or what the fuck's going on here? This, not even a chocolate bunny. This is actually bullshit, I think. Actually, here's a tip for you guys. You guys want us to spend a little more time down there? I'm sure you do. This is, maybe you could try this. Leave some treats. I would stick around longer. There's some jelly beans milling around in there somewhere. Oh, that's delicious. I'm going back. That is fun. But don't do the crazy stuff like we do, right? Because we do too much, I admit it. Like, we don't care. You don't have to wax. Just do something, though. Like, Brill Cream. Do a comb over. I'll take that. That's fine. Just... Looks like Donald Trump in your pants. You're fired. No. I want to do a little audience participation right now. I watch a lot of late night television, like the Home Shopping Channel. Does anybody have parents who watch the Home Shopping Channel? I'm up late, just the one guy. Great. Okay, this is for you. But you've seen it, right? Everybody's seen the Home Shopping Channel. You got nothing to watch, and I'm up late, and I realize that lady is the happiest woman in the world, isn't she? She's so happy, and I don't know how they sell everything they do, but they make it look like the most amazing thing in the world. Like, for example, you, my friend, can I borrow your, I'll take your cup. I'm gonna sell that. How about that? This is every QVC lady. What is your name, by the way? Patrick. All right, thanks. Go, Patrick. All right.
This is one of my favorite items. Item J99357, can we get another camera angle on that in the back, please, Steve? Yeah. Look at what I just noticed in the studio. Look at the way the light just cascades off of that rim. It is eye-catching, isn't it? Take a look at that. Now, I want to show you something. Zoom in. I want to show you this special feature that we have here, if you notice. Look at the attention to detail. There's actually grooves that are manipulated into that scientifically, into that cup. So it keeps it from falling out of your hand. Isn't that great? Take a look at that. Look how easy. I could do this for days. I could just keep doing it. What's great about this is sometimes, you know, you go, cheese and rice, I don't know. Well, how much liquid will that hold? What if it's empty? What if it's full? You can see that it's actually see-through. So you can spot that from several feet away. Take a look at that. I know whether it has to be topped off or not. That is a feature that is included. You didn't even pay for that. That's included. I know what you're wondering. How do you get that kind of quality for that price? I know it's amazing. Well, I'll tell you how. We have these handcrafted by a small family in Indonesia. And you know, they will work for a peanut butter sandwich and a Mentos. So then we pass those savings. Isn't that fantastic? Let's go ahead and measure real quick. Go ahead, zoom in, Steve. So that is a solid 3¾ inch tall. Look at that, 3¾ inch. That's pretty amazing. Or, 7½, according to my husband, Stu. Come on. All right. Thank you so much, Patrick. Thank you. So they actually are selling, I'm not making this up, they're selling vibrators on the show. That's why I brought it up, actually. I could not believe this poor woman had to sell Hawk a Dong on national television. Like, how horrifying. But she did it like a champ. She's like, this is one of my favorite items. Item J990069, you know, I was almost late getting to the studio today because of this number right here. It's called the Happy Beaver. That's true. I do a lot of stuff, you know, off the beaten path, and lately I've been trying different things. I finally went to sing karaoke. Any karaoke fans? I saw some up here on stage earlier. That was rocking. I love it. And you know what? If you don't like to sing, just go to watch people, because how fun was that, right? I went to an authentic Asian karaoke club, even better, though, because you hear the original, then the Vietnamese version of every song. Did you know that? It's like a cultural experience. I had fun, but I sang some Alanis Morissette. I wasn't prepared, though, you know? I didn't know what was going on. So I was like, it's not fair to deny me of the cross I bear that you gave to me. Yeah, hot and no. Woo! Rock on, thank you. And then I will later. I'll karaoke after I breastfeed you. We'll do it. We'll do the whole thing. I'm going to wax his balls. It's going to be great. Anyway, so. He's going to hold me to it. He's going to hold it. Okay. Anyway, so. But then I heard the same song in Vietnamese. I'm not making it up. Minh Dai So, Luc Tam Hai Ma, Mi Mai Ma Pa Bon Tam Lach Chin Moi Bac Dong Gai Sat, Yot, 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 In Do Ma. I was totally rocking out anyway, but then I got confused. I was like, oh, shit, I got to quit drinking. I don't know what the hell she's saying. What the hell's going on? Asian women are sexy, though. I got to hand it to you. Some men will only date Asian women now. You know that? Yeah, that's become very popular. There's actually a nickname for these guys. They're called congressmen. And can't blame them. Asian women are sexy. They're exotic. They're petite. They got that gorgeous hair. I guess the one great equalizer, though, Vietnamese is not the most seductive language. I'm gonna grant that it's not French, it's not Spanish. English isn't either, but you can at least attempt to seduce somebody with English, right? Like, honey, why don't you put on some music and I'll try on that new lingerie and I wanna make love. Try that in Vietnamese. Yan, sarak marak pinga ya tak song mo kon tapare tanda kan makan nangai pengdu ya tangai ya pengeta yai toma.
Oh man, watch a lot of television. Watch a lot of stupid shows. You know what I watched recently? A celebrity Wheel of Fortune. None of the celebrities knew what the hell they were doing. Why? They always screw it up on game shows, right? And so, interesting group. It was Al Pacino, Fran Drescher, Gilbert Gottfried, Julia Roberts, and Joan Rivers. You know what? Actually, I'm gonna switch this up right now. I'm gonna do Celebrity Survivor. I'm gonna put them in a different situation because this is more of a survivor group, right? You guys probably watched that instead, right? So let's do that. Let's do Al Pacino, Fran Drescher, Gilbert Gottfried, Julia Roberts, and Joan Rivers if they were on Celebrity Survivor. I think that's better for you guys. Here we go. What the fuck is going on here? Now, you know what, Fran? You got a great ass. You got your head all the way up it. Hoo-ah! You know what, Al? You're kind of sexy when you're angry. Oh my God! Make her stop laughing, God! I can't take it. I would rather have a prickly midget shoved up my ass right now. Hey, Julia, watch out. You got a spider on your foot.
Julia, stop crying. You look like a horse face when you cry like that. What are you, Mustang Sally? You think you got problems? I am running. I am sweating. My plastic surgery is melting off my face right now. Oh my God. Look, I'm playing hacky sack with my tits. You guys are awesome. Thank you so very much.